This is America. How does it make you feel? Uncomfortable? Confused? Shocked? Amused? Sad? On a subconscious, emotional, primitive level? How does it make you feel? From the millisecond the music video for Childish Gambino's This Is America dropped, the video has been analyzed and deconstructed and appropriated and parodied and... what? Which makes sense, because there is a ton to dissect here. The Jim Crow symbolism, parallels to real-world shootings, there's a horse right there. One of the more popular theories is that the dancing is a distraction from the violence happening in the background. But despite endless speculation, I never found a satisfying and definitive meaning behind the video. That is, until I saw him. At 3 minutes and 34 seconds into the video, visible for only 15 frames, the Rosetta Stone, the key to this entire puzzle, the water bottle man. Who is he? What is his significance? What does the water bottle symbolize? The water crisis in Flint? Our thirst for power and fame? Our standing in the shadows, unwilling to douse the metaphorical fires of humanity? What secrets is he hiding in that pouch? And the baseball cap makes it undeniably clear that the water bottle man is Childish Gambino's frequent collaborator, Chance the Rapper. I mean, that's just obvious, but wait, is that a second water bottle? And that's when I finally realized. This is really stupid. Not the video, but my trying to make literal sense of the video. I mean, Childish Gambino himself refuses to make literal sense of the video.
Can you explain what's happening at the end of that video?
No.
And once you stop trying to make literal sense of the video starts making a lot more sense. And that's because Gambino isn't trying to construct a logical, straightforward narrative. He's communicating irrationally, and mostly through the emotional language of juxtaposition. Now allow me to explain the rationale behind that irrationality. Rationale behind the irrationality. Yeah, that makes sense, ish. Childish Gambino, aka Donald Glover, is complex. Some might say enlightened. He might say enlightened. He seems excessively confident in his understanding of the universe, talking about reality and interactions as an algorithm.
Yo, first I want to thank, you know, the great algorithm that put us all here.
He even says in an interview with The New Yorker, "I feel like Jesus. I do feel chosen," which came off to me as not unpretentious. I've always been more of a Socrates guy with the whole "a wise man knows one thing, and that's that he knows nothing," but considering this is the guy who accused Socrates of f***ing boys, it sort of adds up. No hands like Socrates, y'all boys like Socrates. But he's actually not that far off from what Socrates was saying. The thing that Glover has figured out, more so than just about any other popular artist out there, is that the world doesn't make logical sense. Humans don't make logical sense, but it is possible to see the patterns, the algorithm, in that illogic. See, human beings suck at logic. There is not a single purely logical human being out there. We are a mess of primitive and obsolete instincts and urges. There is no logic behind making a weapon that can destroy the entirety of the human race. There is no logic in my hating going to work so I can make money and buy clothes when you better believe I'm gonna spend 8 hours grinding for coins so I can buy Mario the most elegant of wedding gowns. And there's no logic in racism. There's no logic in being terrified of an unarmed black man. Humans are not purely logical beings, which is becoming more and more true with beliefs and decisions becoming based almost entirely on emotions over facts. And Donald Glover knows this, which is why when he wants to communicate an idea, he doesn't just throw a bunch of statistics at you. Even if they're factual, people don't care about statistics. Donald Glover, Childish Gambino, communicates his ideas through evoking emotions. And one of the most effective ways to communicate purely emotionally is through the use of juxtaposition. Juxtaposition, noun, the act or an instance of placing two or more things side by side, often to compare or contrast or create an interesting effect. Around a century ago, Russian filmmaker Lev Kuleshov famously demonstrated what's now known as the Kuleshov effect, which is displayed here by Alfred Hitchcock. Cutting between a shot of Hitchcock smiling and a woman with her child, he comes off as a soft-hearted old man. But intercut that exact same shot of Hitchcock with a woman in a bikini, and now he's a big old pervo. An image can take on an entirely different meaning when juxtaposed with another image, despite literally nothing about that image changing. That's the power of juxtaposition. And much like the motifs in Hamilton that I talked about in my first video, it can be used to create some extremely complex and even paradoxical emotions. One of my favorite uses of juxtaposition can be seen in the music video for Acid Rain by Lorne, which takes two tropes you've seen a million times, the cheap shock of a car crash and the cliched sexuality of a dancing cheerleader, and combines them. But the result is neither shocking nor sexual, unless you're like real weird. Instead, the result is this sense of discomfort and dread that is bordering on straight-up horror. And Glover takes that approach and says, hey, what if I just crank that up to a billion? Glover's use of juxtaposition started long before This Is America. His last album, Awaken My Love, used the juxtaposition of classic R&B and archetypal horror imagery to recreate the anxiety of being black in America that is right up there with Get Out. And the insane juxtaposition of tones in his TV show Atlanta is used pretty much constantly. Just look at Darius warning Earn about the mythical Florida man, with the sequence moving from the uncomfortable realism of Florida man shooting an unarmed black teen, to the absurd comedy of him beating up a flamingo, to the terrifying visual of him eating a dude's face, all in the span of 23 seconds. It creates this lack of emotional footing that is equal parts riveting and horrifying. And all of those techniques are utilized and intensified in This Is America. This Is America is soup to nuts juxtaposition. The most obvious example is the violence and the chaos interwoven with the grinning schoolchildren and the dancing. But there are even more layers of juxtaposition within that juxtaposition. The American viral dances like the shoot dance juxtaposed with South African dances like the guara guara, or the juxtaposition of guns being treated delicately while bodies are carelessly dragged away, or that rap video trope of being surrounded by fancy cars and beautiful women, wait, is that SZA? Juxtaposed with the use of a bunch of cheap, unimpressive cars. Even the music itself is a harsh juxtaposition of joyful gospel and heavy southern trap music. And This Is America takes the actual editing out of the Kuleshov effect, putting the juxtaposed imagery, the gleeful dancing and the rioting, in the same frame, because the video wouldn't be half as resonant if it was simply cutting between separate shots of dancing and violence. And that's the brilliance that a lot of people seem to be missing. That's why I disagree with the theory that the children dancing distract us from the violence. It's the opposite. When asked about that distraction theory, This Is America's amazing choreographer, Sherry Silver, said, "You could say distract, but I say contrast." If the music video was just a series of violent images, we wouldn't care. We're too desensitized to it anymore. But when you throw in some dancing kids and weird Donald Glover faces, the video suddenly hits you. The dancing isn't distracting us from the violence. It's what's making us actually notice the violence. It's that irrationality, that contrast, that juxtaposition. In the New Yorker interview, Donald Glover said, "I tell stories because that's the best way of spreading information. We're all tricking and toying and playing with each other's senses to affect this thing hidden inside our skulls. Donald Glover isn't trying to preach at us. He's communicating with us and challenging us on an irrational, emotional level so that we can come to our own conclusions. And in that way, ironically, he's sort of like Socrates. Socrates would reason with people using what we now call the Socratic method. I mean, he might have called it that too. I don't know how narcissistic he was. The Socratic method is, instead of just telling someone they're right or wrong, you ask them a series of questions that challenges their belief, so that they're forced to confront the lapses in their own logic through their responses and come to their own realizations organically. In that same way, This Is America doesn't tell you what's right or wrong. It just shows you the emotional state of America right now through that juxtaposition and through symbolism without any clear narrative or message. The video simply tells you, this is America. Then it asks you, how does it make you feel? And it lets you come to your own conclusions. And personally, how it made me feel was scared. Because after that first gunshot, there's no more comfort, no more safety, no more innocence. Suddenly, something terrible could happen at any second. The juxtaposition of that violence makes everything else constantly terrifying. It poisons the whole thing. No matter how happy those dancing kids are, no matter how bright and uplifting the music is, that violence is always in the background, always in the back of your mind. You're always waiting for it. It's horrifying. To me, this is America. How does it make you feel? Hey gals, guys, and otherwise, if you dug this video but thought to yourself, God, I wish he'd cover literally everything else about Donald Glover, boy, do I have a surprise for you. My friend Medium D just released a video covering pretty much everything Donald Glover that I didn't talk about in this video over on his YouTube channel, Medium D Speaks. It is fantastic. He is fantastic. It is pretty much a part two to this video. So go watch it and tell him Make Stuff sent you. Give him a hello. And if you really dug the video, go check out the Make Stuff Patreon over at patreon.com/roselion. There are tons of exclusive videos and comics and giveaways, plus you'll get access to every Make Stuff video 1 week before everyone else for just $1 a month. Double plus, you can get a shout out at the end of each video, like these devilishly charming stuff makers. TC Arkenberg, I admire you greatly. Sandy Swagger, I also admire you greatly. Houston, I greatly admire you. Oh, I mixed it up there. Shannon, I esteem you largely. Thank you, Thesaurus. Sirtra, I admire you so greatly that I learned how to communicate it in sign language. Here we go. Nailed it. And Rochi, you gave me so much money that I was able to buy this robot specifically to tell you
that I admire you greatly.
And shout out to all these other wonderful stuff makers. You are the wind beneath my Patreon. Thank you. Anyway, go check out the Patreon. Go check out Medium D's new video. And as always, go make stuff.